What's up, guys? Today's quick tip is going to be going over something called quantize, or time quantize to be precise. Stick around. Alright guys, so in today's video, I thought I'd do a little quick tip of something that actually happened to me, and you know, maybe it's happened to you, so I thought, you know, go ahead and do a quick tip and show you what I did to fix the problem. Basically what happened was, I have been recording with MIDI, using it for the drums, using it for the bass, stuff like that, and I've never had a problem with it, always fine. One day I woke up, recorded a drum sequence, it sounded fine recording, playing back live was like this. I'm going to show you, give you an example of what happened to me. So obviously I'm not perfect tempo there, but still, you get the drift, pretty on par. And so all I did there was just, oh, I'm so happy I did all that work. Let me go ahead and play it back now. I did not just do that, you know. I know it was 100% on beat, but I did not just do that. So very confusing. Not very good and very frustrating. Took me quite a while to find out the actual issue in my situation. The way GarageBand is, or at least was, it was pretty straightforward. For some reason, I don't know what happened. I don't know if it was just me. Maybe it's just me, or maybe it was you too. But for some reason, something happened, and it completely messed everything up. So, all I did was, once I figured it out, now from now on, I always have to do this. So I don't know why it's doing this now, because like I said, I never had to do this before, but now I always have to do this. Basically what you do is, for most of you, if you're recording, usually this is kind of how it looks, so you can hear back and you might want to mess with stuff. So if you don't have this clicked, go ahead and click it, in this situation, your editor. Now as you can see, you have the score, that's how that looks, piano roll, but this is where I want you to pay attention to, the time quantize. It's tricky because, like I said, normally this wasn't a problem. This time, for some reason, it always, when I record, even though I'm recording fine, it records it and it has the 1/16 note. It's an easy, very easy fix, but it took me forever to figure it out. I looked online. I couldn't find any help at all. This is all you do. Time quantize, off. Now listen to it. Just like the way I did, off tempo. But that's it. That's all you have to do. I don't know, like I said, why all of a sudden GarageBand had that. Time quantize has always been there, but I never had a problem with it. Usually with time quantize, you turn it on, not off, in the sense of it's already off, especially if you're doing manually your tracks. You know, if I had done a track with a drummer in, I could understand. But in this case, that happened. So if it's happened to you, or if you're struggling with the same situation, that should fix it. All you got to do is go to time quantize, off, you're good to go. But that's my little quick tip. Be sure to subscribe. Once a week I'm doing videos for sure. I'm trying to do some more, but right now my time is kind of tight. So one video once a week, and I do tips like this as far as not just GarageBand, but recording, as you can see in my room. That's how I'm going to be recording my EP that I'm recording right now. And, you know, just so we can connect, please be sure to go with Twitter, Google+, Facebook. And Google+, a lot of communities there, so that's good. You can always go check that out for some help too. But if you have any questions, be sure to comment or shoot me a message on Google+, and I'll be sure to get back to you. But thanks so much for watching. Have a great night, day, week, whenever you're watching this, and I'll see you on the next video.